Herzlich willkommen zum Schulungsvideo Dieter Schur der Firma Büfer Reinigungssysteme. Ich bin Peter Schwarz.
Welcome to Büfer Reinigungssystem Stain Removal Training Video with my colleague Peter Schwarz. Let's talk about spotting and stain removal. What do we mean by spotting and stain removal? By spotting or stain removal, we mean the local removal of stains caused by wearing. These stains should be removed, as 100% stain removal is the hallmark of textile cleaning.
Der Textilreiniger entscheidet darüber, ob das Kleidungsstück für den Endverbraucher noch tragbar ist oder nicht.
Note that we distinguish between two different types of stains. We have water-based, or so-called aqueous stains, and we have oily or fatty stains. The basic principle of stain removal is based on this knowledge. Always remove like with like. So, first let us look at the different compositions of the individual stains, their substance. This is removed with a spotting agent containing a solvent. These include oil paint and gloss paint removers. Both of these spotting agents are able to remove oily and fatty stains because they contain a solvent. In the next group, we have water-based substances, for which we take our protein remover, Bloodex. This can be used to treat any stains containing protein. These include all stains originating from the animal world or from us humans. A protein stain is an alkaline stain, and so it has to be removed with a spotting agent that contains water and alkali. In the next group of stains with a water content, we have substances originating from the plant world, such as stains caused by grass or moss, but also from beverages. These substances are acidic.
Vom pH-Wert her und beinhalten etwas Wasser. Demzufolge
they have to be removed with a spotting agent that contains a mild acid, such as Tannex, our tannin remover. The bottles are colored green, just as the majority of our plant world is green. By contrast, our protein remover, Bloodex, is in red bottles. Still looking at the water-based stains, let's move on to starch stains. By starch, we mean everything made from rice, potatoes, or cereals. Such stains are water-soluble, or rather, they swell on contact with water. They can be removed with a water-based stain remover, a tannin remover. The next type of water-based stains contains sugar. We have two types of sugar. Beet sugar is generally used for sweetening foodstuffs. Such stains can also be removed with a tannin remover, as they consist of plant sap. Then we have stains from fruit sugar. These originate from fruits, for example cherries or raspberries, as well as from fruit juices. The tannin remover is applied here too. That is the green bottle. Often, these stains also contain dyes. In this instance, the dye must be destroyed and so post-treatment is often required.
Im Nachhinein oft noch nachbehandelt werden und der Farbstoff muss zerstört werden. Dies geschieht in der Regel.
Medex is suitable here, as it contains bleach to break down the dye.
Dazu gehört ein farbstoffzerstörendes oder bleichmittelhaltiges Detachiermittel, welches wir hier zum Einsatz bringen werden. In der nächsten Gruppe haben wir dann.
In the next group we have rust stains, caused by oxidized iron coming into contact with fabrics. These can be removed with a rust remover, our Ferrex. Finally, we have the group of stains containing pigments. By pigments, we mean tiny, indestructible substances. They can be both oily, for example, makeup, shoe polish, or soot, or aqueous, such as splashes from puddles in the streets. These stains have to be removed with a neutral spotting agent. The best product here is an oil paint remover. This can remove both aqueous and oily pigment-based soiling.
Pigmentschmutz, Verfleckungen entfernen kann.
In order to decide which processing method is the right one, the textiles must be inspected. During the fabric inspection, articles should be examined in detail. They must be checked for stains and damage. Any damage is entered in an appropriate register. In the interest of hygiene, we carry out fabric inspections wearing protective gloves. When examining textiles, we check the garment's pockets. This means that each pocket is turned inside out. Any foreign bodies are removed and, at the same time, any stains that need to be treated in advance can be identified. In the next step, we look at the garment as a whole. Again, we look for stains and any signs of damage. It is also important to note the instructions label. This tells us how a garment may be treated and whether the different agents can be used on it or not. Proper treatment is only possible once the stains have been correctly identified. There are various ways of doing this. Attention should be paid to a stain's shape and form, its position, its color, and its smell. After all, certain stains have a typical odor. For example, the edge profile of a stain defines whether it is an aqueous or oily stain. Here you can see that the edge is very sharp. An oily stain would have a softer, flowing form. This is because oil is slowly drawn into the individual fabric structures. Water-based stains are always clearly defined forms. The position of the stain is naturally also decisive in establishing what kind of stain it is. Stains from food residues are more likely to be found on the front of a garment, not under the arms. Shoe polish, however, would more likely cause stains on the lower parts of trousers, rather than on parts of other garments. The odor is often not perceptible. Smells become more pronounced when the stain is nominally steamed or dampened with water. With delicate textiles, it is advisable to first test the selected spotting agent so as not to cause any damage. That is why we carry out a test on the garment's hem. Of course, while working with the various agents, we wear safety glasses to protect our eyes from any potential splashes. So, a hem test. We use a white cotton cloth, douse it with the chosen spotting agent, and apply it to a concealed part of the garment. We think that this garment has a coffee stain. We therefore conduct the hem test with our tannin remover. Rubbing the agent on the garment's hem will tell us whether the tannin remover can be used without damaging the fabric. The red tan on our white cloth indicates that that is not possible. This spotting agent is not suitable for this garment. When processing undefined stains, it is important to follow a particular sequence. We don't want to fix any stain on any garment. Also, two different stain removers should not cancel each other out. The sequence which we must follow begins with our neutral oil paint remover, followed by our protein remover, and concludes with our tannin remover. It is important to adhere to this sequence. This is because certain agents can be mixed with each other, while others have to be rinsed out. After testing the oil paint remover, we can carry on directly with the protein remover, without rinsing the garment. If we then need to continue and test a tannin remover, we first have to rinse out the treated stain with water. It is quite possible that, during treatment with our tannin remover, certain dyes could not be completely removed. This would typically be the red dye of red wine or fruit juice that remains visible. In this case, the tannin remover should be rinsed out completely, and the stain can then be treated with our dye remover. The stain should be completely doused with the liquid agent and processed until the stain has been removed. If any dye residues still remain thereafter visible, the stain requires further treatment using a bleaching agent.
Oxidativen oder mit einem reduktiven Bleichmittel. Um Flecken entfernen zu können,
to be able to remove stains, we need certain tools, a spatula and a brush specifically designed for stain removal. Both tools are essential in breaking down stains, soaking them and working on them.
Aufzubrechen, einzuweichen und durchzuarbeiten. Das heißt, es wird so gearbeitet, dass wir einen Fleck entfernen wollen, indem wir eine Flecksubstanz
auf. We apply the spotting agent to the surface
und anschließend mit der Bürste
and then work it in with the brush using a pump or even hammer motion. For stubborn stains, we must leave the spotting agent to take effect for a short time. Using the spatula, we scratch the surface of the stain and allow the agent to work. Stubborn stains include, for example, gloss paints or adhesives. We always make a distinction between pre-stain removal and post-stain removal. In pre-stain removal, the fabric to be treated is covered with a specific agent. In post-stain removal, the treated surface is rinsed with water or steam. So, how are stains removed? A certain technique is advisable here. We take the appropriate spotting agent, apply it to the stain, and, using the brush to lightly tap the fabric, work the agent into the stain. We then rinse the area of the stain with water. For this, we either use water from a spray bottle or water that is available from pistols. In post-stain removal, it is important that the area of the stain be dried completely. After the spotting agent has been washed out and the stain has been removed, a mark may remain in the treated area. However, this can easily be removed. This is done by creating a transition from a dry area via a damp area to a wet area. We do this using a steam pressure pistol,
um ein Verziehen der Ränder zu produzieren.
We wish you every success removing stains. We are sure that with the basic knowledge which you have gained today, you will find stain removal a little easier. We would just like to remind you of the three principles in stain removal. Remove like with like, what is gone, and what isn't possible, is possible after all.